And we're back on some Casino Ops 3 today. I got the supply drops for you. Don't worry, guys. Sometimes I don't have them once in a while. And that's usually because when I'm recording, I'm not able to unlock them yet. And I got to usually just wait a little bit longer. But I don't want to wait. So I end up just pushing them back and I do it on stream. So sometimes I don't have them. I'm sorry. Today, though, of course, for your viewing pleasure, you can see me get fucked over again with another 8. Oh, look at that. Got an epic, that's cool. Another 8 supply drops. 6 regulars and 2 blue ones. Rares, whatever. I think rare is an overestimate of their ability. It's just, it's more of a, I call them blue ones. They're blue ones. They're not rare. Okay? I've seen better. Yeah, you've seen better. Well, I don't have enough? Oh, yeah, I forgot. That's weird, I'm surprised I don't have enough. I've been playing the last few days, too. There we go. Got enough now, bitch. Here we go. Give me a deal anyway, come on. I've bought enough of these, I figure you should lower the price at some point. I'm a returning customer. Oh? No? Wow, those both sucked ass. And that's why we call them blue supply drops. Not rare at all. Hardcore search and destroy! That is right, hardcore it is! Hardcore is a pretty small community overall. I mean, there's only... Goodness. 15% of the game, I think it said, that was in hardcore. And of the 15%, only 2 is in search and destroy. So pretty much anyone that plays S&D in this are people that really like S&D. And by really like, I mean they fucking only play this shit. Which is not a big deal. I like playing search a lot too, but not a humongous hardcore player. Which means I'm at a slight disadvantage versus the kids that know life at all the time. Like that guy, my teammate just leaves me. And that's how I figured there was more back in their spawn. I knew I had bomb. I didn't want to push back there. I figured I should play the objective, make him come to me. I see him out of the corner of my eye. He doesn't shoot because he's slow as shit. And then dies. The Razorback was nerfed in hardcore though. It was made a 2-shot over a 1-shot at ranges like that. Which makes it a significant amount weaker, but... At the same time, it's still a very good gun, mainly because it has no recoil. No recoil weapons typically dominate a hardcore the game mode, the hardcore playlist. Holy smokes. My team's going in right now. Is that a guy back there? Is that my guy? Can't tell. I wonder he fell off. Yeah, it was my guy. I hear a guy on my team using the DY or DIY 11 Reno. Oh my god, M8 dude trying to camp me out. Ooh, M8 dude in the back of the spawn. Oh, he's bad though. Holy shit. What a nerd. Camp with an M8. Dude, it's just like regular. Just like regular S&D. It's no different. Everyone's playing the exact same. I wonder if that DY-11 or DIY-11 renovator is good in this. It seems like it could one-shot people at almost any range, which is pretty strong, but the fact that you have to lead shots is a large disadvantage, in my opinion. A large disadvantage over most other weapons in the game, and I have a problem now. Okay, solve my problem for now. Please do not sound horny. Me. Alright, we made it in. Oh, we saw one there. We're going for a kill. Got one kill. Nice. And there was a second one on the other corner. We took a beat. I think there was a second one on the other corner. Or in the stairwell camping. One of the two. They set up hard in the bomb site though. They're camping all around in the back of the spawn and inside the bomb site. Nice shot. I wish I would have died to someone like that with talent instead of someone in a corner. Ready, boy. That'd been nicer. I would have felt better about myself at least. Protect the objectives. Alright, let's try this again. This might work out, this might not. I never actually shot any players going this way, so. Nice! M8? Nope. One shot from a KN-44 from that range. Yeah, I mean, that's the disadvantage of the Razorback now. I can't one shot like that. They can. I could use an MA. I mean, I'm not going to use any. I'm using a Razorback specifically because I wanted to play with it in hardcore and test it out some more since the nerf. I could use an LMG. Almost every LMG in the game is a one-shot in hardcore at any range. The Gorgon, the Dingo especially, is the most overpowered one. But I still want to rock the Razorback. I want to give the Razorback some love because that's what I used a lot of when I was doing most of my challenges in hardcore. You guys watch for a while, you know I have 100% multiplayer. I completed every challenge of the game for multiplayer. And a lot of the times I had to go to hardcore for specific challenges. Certain weapons especially. Like Gorgon headshots really suck in core. But in hardcore it's not too bad. It's like shooting a Shiva, basically. You just gotta make sure you hit your headshot, you're good. But the Razorback was the one I had to do a lot of hardcore with, so I've been trying to give it some love, mess around with it a bit, and I felt like that would be a fun video today to try, because I don't really post a lot of hardcore. One shot by Nemate again. It's just one shot. I mean, one shot of the four round burst hits you, you're dead. But that's why hardcore is so easy for bad players. No accuracy is required. That's why I've always thought hardcore is bad and very much lacking in skill, is because you can just basically play with any weapon that's semi-strong and hipfire the whole time and get kills. So maybe we'll do that for a challenge one day too. Just like go into hardcore with like a laser sight VMP or laser sight Dingo. Laser sight Dingo and hipfire the whole time. That might be good. I think we could do that. No shit, I think we could probably do that. Rapid fire laser sight Dingo. Something that's so stupid, but I bet it would work. I bet I could play hardcore and never aim for a second and do relatively well if I gave it some shots. Where's bomb? This guy. Dude camping stairwell on you? Nope.
The bomb has been planted.
That our guy? Yeah, it was this guy. Okay. I think we should try that. You guys let me know. I don't know if you actually like hardcore or not. You let me know. If you think that'd be fun little challenge to do and to prove my point. I did it back in Black Ops 2. Not sure what gun I used. I think it was the Peacekeeper back then. I played BO2, used the Peacekeeper, hip-fired all game long, and I think I dropped like 15 kills in S&D on raid. It was insane. And insanely easy, too. And this guy just doesn't... These guys do not... I've never heard of dead silence and awareness in their entire life. I think we lost. This guy's too far away to actually play the objective, which is typical.
Bomb deactivated.
Yep, that's unfortunate.
We lost the battle, but the war
that's unfortunate.
Bring your A-game.
Playing a squad of people... Squad of sheeples with a whole team of kids that are level 300 that have never heard of dead silence in their life. Their team, dead silence, blast suppressor. It's been 10 years. Can you fucking idiots just put on dead silence? I mean, every goddamn game I play in Search, I have to fucking tell people. It isn't changing. It's the same every game. Just put on dead silence, you idiots. Holy shit, how many stupid people play this stuff? It's just kind of annoying, like... Only so much you can deal with people never using dead silence. It's the best perk for this game mode. It's always been the best perk in every game. Oh, maybe except Modern Warfare 3, and that's only because the sit rep change was broken, which we all know. Sit rep pro has changed to be fucking, what was that, Soundhor god tier. Is that my guy? Yeah, he is. I was wondering who had the loudest fucking footsteps in the game. Only my team would refuse to use dead silence, so not a surprise, I guess.
We do it.
There we go. Okay, 3-3. Game's tied. Let's do it, boys. This is your... There we go. I got a player using a dead silence and an M8. This is my champion right here. Freddy boy. Fred boy 007. This guy. Level 582. He figured it out. Dead silence is the way to rock it. I like you, Fred. I don't know who the three or four other people that aren't using dead silence are, but you know what you're doing. You got your shit together.
Protect the objectives.
I don't do this route ever, but I think it might work out in hardcore, because a lot of people do not seem to play very aggressive in this game mode. And then my teammate Freddy Boy just fell off the map. Well. That's a feels bad, man. Rest in peace, Freddy Boy. If I walk out here, what are the chances I die? 90%? He was in that corner the whole time. I was wondering. I felt like it was a 90% I'd die. You guys get him? Nice, we got him, I think. God, I want to play aggressive, but I know I'm gonna get camped out. It's just, it's one of those bad feelings. Alright, we'll go in here. I think it's safe. Dude, I feel sketched. Is that a player I saw? Nope, okay. 9-3! Not bad. The Razorback nerf is definitely noticeable, though. I haven't played a lot of hardcore since the nerf. I did play a good amount before it because of the challenges I was doing. Definitely noticeable. That KN44 death, I would have been able to one-shot that guy. I would have killed him. Like, it used to one-shot at that range. It was really good. It's a beautiful thing. And that's strange on why they nerfed it, because, I mean, naturally, you know, you want weapon balancing, but they've never really nerfed guns like that in the past in hardcore. Like, the Peacekeeper in BO2 was that strong, and it was never nerfed. So for some reason, I guess they wanted to mess with stuff in this game. They didn't change it in Respawn, though. It was just only nerfed in hardcore. GG! Give him that boast. Never got my kinetic armor, which is really strong in hardcore, but never got it. I see a lot of people in hardcore rocking Rejack as well. I would not call that a good one, but... I mean, maybe it is. Maybe I haven't played enough hardcore to see it. I think I'm ranked decently high in this game mode, too. Even though I haven't played a lot. That's usually how you do get ranked up highly, is play a little bit, do decent, and never play it again. I'll find out in a second when the stupid Treyarch symbol steps swirling around on my screen. Come on. Finish your black screen of death. There we go. 50 seconds later. Yeah, top 300. It's not bad. Not as good as my respawn, or not as good as my regular S&D, but that's just because I can play aggressive in that and not get camped out all day. Either way, GG. Beat a squad. I'm surprised. Hope you guys enjoyed some hardcore. If you're down for the dingo strat, maybe we'll do that sometime. Let me know. Need feedback on that. Maybe you guys don't like hardcore at all, and I won't do it, but just thought I'd throw it out there. Thanks for watching. I will see you all next time. Bye-bye.